Hello students, welcome to e-Pathasala. Myself, I am Saravanan, working as assistant professor at Kumaruri College of Technology. Today, we are going to discuss about the module anti-static and anti-pilling finishes. Introduction about the module. Static electricity can cause many processing problems for textile materials, especially those made from hydrophobic synthetic fibers. In most dry textile processes for fibers and fabrics, they move at high speeds over various surfaces, which can generate electrostatic charges due to frictional forces. This electrical charge can cause fibers and the yarns to repel each other, leading to balloon formation. Fabrics and even nanowovens are also affected by these static charges that causes material handling problems. Consumers are well aware of the clinging of garments and the small electrical shocks caused by walking on carpets in low humidity conditions. Computers and other electronic equipment can be damaged by these static charges. Static electricity tends to build up mostly in wool and synthetic fiber blended fabrics due to their lack of moisture regain and conductivity property. This can be reduced only by anti-static agents, which usually forms a thin layer of moisture and neutralizes the fabric surface without static charges. Anti-static can be either durable or non-durable type of finishes. Some examples of durable anti-stats are polyamines, polyethoxylated amine and ammonium salts, even carboxylic salts. In case of non-durable antistats are quaternary ammonium salts, phosphate esters and ethyloxylated fatty acids. Another is pilling. It usually during wear can be observed in both woven as well as knitted, mainly in wool fabrics. Even blended apparels and garments also affected by pilling, causing the failure of the garment in the normal sense. That reduces its aesthetic appeal. Generally, pilling is to be greater problem in blended fabrics than in pure wool because high-strength synthetic fibers anchor the pills to the fabric surface, preventing the removal during wear. A number of processes have been there to improve the pilling performance of woolen apparels, mainly without the formation of pills. For example, the degradative anti-felting finishes, mainly by chlorination, that assists without formation of pills by anti-pilling finishes. Objective of the module. Module aims to discuss the following core points and elaborate them in detail for clear understanding and appreciate the importance of surface-oriented finishes, such as both anti-static and anti-pilling, mainly for the textile materials. Objective number one, numerous description about the role of static and pills on the textile surface and their influence on actual working is discussed here. The second one, various methods to control the formation of pills on fabric surface and various steps to eliminate the static charges that gets generated on the fabric surface. Objective number three, the role of chemicals, surfactants, softeners, and developing resistance to textile fabric, mainly against those pills and static charges. The last objective is mechanism or usually principle on which these finishing agents works on the fabric surface is also illustrated in this module. The first, we see about protective garment preparation using finishes for static electricity. Static electricity is accumulation of charges in one space. Charges of over 200 volts can give a shock to a person when it discharges on the fabric surface. It can even damage electronic equipments. A spark generated during discharge can cause fire or even explosion. Usually, it can attract dust particles so that opposite charges settle on textile and it causes spark. Thus, the kind of static charges is also influenced by the cloth clinging to our body. Where are these are critical? Industries such as solvents and fuel production units, explosives production units, operation theaters and wards, electronic industry, and even oil rig operation. These finishes absorb moisture from atmosphere and dissipate the static charges developed on the fabric surface. The problem with these type, they tend to lose over a period of flame, mainly on the fabric. Washing and dry cleaning slowly remove these finishes, hence durability is prime important. There are basically three types to produce permanent anti-static garment: fibers that have internal additives which are capable of conducting charges during spinning itself. Second method is fibers that contain conducting additives internally or on the surface as a part of fiber present on the yarn. The last one is metallic fibers and yarns can be used, the permanent anti-static garments. Fibers that have internal additives are capable of conducting charges. Mainly synthetic fibers, usually polyamides, incorporated with additives to increase the hydrophilicity. Sheet core bicomponent fiber with carbon particles dispersed in the fabric surface also able to form anti-static effect. Fibers with coating a metal salt such as copper sulfate also produces anti-static property. And the last one is carbon core. When you talk about fibers, metallic fibers, if they are 100%, it can be covered by the normal fiber such as cotton ash sheet, so that together the structure can be used as anti-static material. Anti-static finishes are used for the removal in synthetic fibers of the unwanted effects of electrostatic charge produced during production and even the wear of the woven fabrics and knitted fabrics. Electrostatic charge causes an undesirable adhesive power, and as a result, it looks the surface to be shabby. It is applied by means of anti-static chemical treatment, which might be a temporary or permanent. Usually, there are two types of anti-static finishes. Number one is non-durable finish. Second one is durable finish. When you discuss on non-durable finishes, these anti-static agents are preferred for fibers and even for yarn, since ease of removal is quite easy. Other important requirements of spin finish and fiber lubricants are heat resistance and oil solubility. Generally, the anti-static agents tend to develop hygroscopic materials, which can be done by surfactants, organic salts, glycols, polyethylene glycols, polyelectrolyte, quaternary ammonium salts with fatty alkyl chains, polyethylene oxide compounds, and esters of salts of alkyl phosphonium acids. General requirement for non-durable anti-stats are should be low volatility, low flammability, non-yellowing, non-corrosive, and low foaming. When you talk on durable antistatics, obtaining the properties durable to repeated launderings from single finish to multiple. The ways to achieve, it works on the basic principle to form a cross-linked polymer network, again containing the hydrophilic groups. Typically, polyamines are reacted with polyglycols to make these kind of structures. Polymers can be formed prior to application to fabrics, or they can be formed in situ on the fiber surface, on the fabric surface after padding application. Cross-linking approaches is numerous in numbers. One such is based on polyepoxides. The hydrophilic character introduction on the fabric surface is prime important, can be done by final polymer to meet the individual requirements. Again, the hydrophilic portions, if it is there, it absorbs more moisture and thereby have the more efficiency of anti-static effects on the fabric. At high levels of absorbed moisture, the polymer surface film softens and is more easily removed by abrasion during laundering. Thus, higher degrees of cross-linking will reduce the moisture absorption and subsequently swelling, but the anti-static effectiveness decreases parallelly. In durable, you have polyhydroxyl polyamines, even polyalkylene, and sometimes polyacrylic copolymers. The mechanism on which these anti-static finishes works is mainly on the equivalent to lowering the surface resistivity, so that the increase of conductivity of the fiber surface takes place on the fabric, thus reduces the frictional forces by lubrication. When you talk on surface resistivity, it is defined as a material property of a substance whose numerical value is equal to the ratio of voltage gradient to the current density. The resistivity is in effect the resistance of the fiber to electrical flow. When you increase conductivity, it produces a lower charge buildup and thus a more rapid dissipation takes place. While it increases the lubricity, it decreases the initial charge buildup. The fiber surface conductivity form an intermediate layer on the fabric surface by the antistatic agents. The mechanism it works is typically hygroscopic. Increased moisture content leads to higher conductivity. It happens because of the mobile ions on the fabric surface. This is very important for increasing the conductivity of the fabric surface. Antistatic finishes depends primarily and heavily on the humidity of the surrounding air during the actual use. Lower humidity leads to lower conductivity and greater problems with static electricity. When you study on non-polymeric antistatic finishes, it is obtained by surfactants that they can orient themselves in specific ways on the fiber surfaces. The hydrophobic structure parts of the molecule acts as lubricants to reduce charge buildup, particularly true with cationic antistatic surfactants that align with the hydrophobic group away from the fabric surface. Again, cationic softeners are most widely used. The main antistatic effect from non-ionic surfactants is increased conductivity through the mobile ions. The surface orientation of these kind of finished fabric surfaces mainly have hydrated layer at the air interface. Water, it is implemented as an antistatic agent because of the conductivity of the electrolytes it holds. It is cheap, non-toxic and non-flammable. Natural fibers, they are inherently hydrophobic in nature, allows them to hold water molecules, which gives them some conductivity, reducing the problem of static charge buildup. But in case of synthetic fibers, they do not allow for a high water regain. That's antistatic agents are required to encourage the presence of water in those textile surface. Surfactants have a hydrophobic head and a hydrophobic tail. The phobic head is embedded within the synthetic material and the hydrophilic and head attracts water and salts to create a dissipative layer, which is shown in the diagram. These surfactants relies upon atmospheric conditions as well as the ability to attract a surface layer that may be suitable for clean room applications. These surfactants are applied at fabric finishing stages and often found in fabric softeners. The life of the product are often lost during the laundering process. In case of environmental impact of using them on such a wide scale, the safety is prime important. Antistatic property can be brought out by reducing the charge by increasing the conduction power of the fabric surface. Most of the antistatic finishes are based on first mechanism, that is by reducing the charge and increasing the surface conduction. The different chemicals used to achieve the antistatic on fabric surfaces: silicone emulsions, polyethylene emulsions, polyethylene glycols, polyammonium quaternary salts, acrylic polymers sometimes used for these kind of purposes. Silicone emulsions, which are used, produces antistatic property but reduces the friction between the fibers with added advantages of soil release property, softness, etc. Commercial antistatic agents for synthetic fibers available in the industries are cerazole, ceramine, antista oil, antista D, antistatic oil and antistatin C, D and M with the commercial names. Antistatic finished fabrics have wider applications. Even after dyeing or printing, it's more common with hydrophobic fibers and fabrics made from cotton, rayon and even wool. The textile products mainly with antistatic finishes important are carpets for computer rooms, upholstery fabrics and airbags for automobiles, conveyor belts, filtration fabrics, parachutes, hospital fabrics, protective clothing for the workers with flammable gases, liquids and powdered solids. The next one is anti-pilling finishes. Pilling is one of the major quality problems in spunyon fabrics, particularly made from synthetic fibers and their blends. Pilling is a fabric defect which appears as small balls attached to the fabric surface by fibers. These balls are quite different from the balls observed frequently with the textured filament yarn fabric. The pills are found only during wear and washing due to abrasion affecting the fabric surface appearance. Even sometimes touch and handle of the fabric due to abrasion, pills are formed. Disposable of the garments long before they reach their normal wear life results in customer dissatisfaction. Migration to fibers on fabric surface are mainly due to abrasion and formation of fuss. Fuss is nothing but it's an entangled fiber ends that protrudes from the surface of the yarn on the fabric. Fuss is observed in different areas, mainly in pockets, under the arms, sleeves, collars, knees and edges of the garments. The first formation tendency is different for different fibers, and there mainly depends on the tenacity of the fiber. Lower interfiber friction, as also fiber stiffness in terms of fiber modulus, facilitates the migration of fibers quite out of the fabric surface. When the first formation reaches the critical level of sufficient density, sometimes with its length, high tenacity fibers like polyesters, the pill formation starts. During pill formation, if a foreign matter gets caught in the fuss, it can facilitate the pill formation because the fibers get a support to curl themselves around the fabric surface. The last stage is the wear-off stage of the pills from the fabric surface. The wearing of the pills will depend mainly on the breaking strength of the fibers and its abrasion resistance properties. The rate of pill formation and pill wear-off processes balance each other by the number of pills on the fabric that remains at the level depending on quality specification of the fabric. At all stages like fiber migration, fuss formation, pill formation and wear-off processes, pills continuously appears simultaneously. Pill formation is generally a function of rubbing against the fabric. So pills are usually found in the garment areas where rubbing is most prevalent. The first approach to prevent loose fibers from forming the initial fuss is by applying the polymeric coatings that binds the fibers into the fabric surface. These finishes typically includes friction reducing lubricants to minimize the abrasion damage. The most useful polymers are acrylic copolymers, since they can be easily modified to yield though flexible films with good adhesion to fiber surfaces. The second chemical finish approach to reduce pilling is to cause the pills to fall off the fabric as soon as they are formed. It is accomplished by reducing the fiber strength. Synthetic fibers, the changes in the polymer structure prior to the extrusion also reduces the pill formation. 100% cotton fabrics, by having the treatment with durable press agents to provide durable press properties, thus reducing the fiber strength sufficiently to improve the pilling performance. The last approach is enzymatic finishes. By use of cellulose enzymes during wet processing itself, can remove enough of the loose fibers that stays in the yarn so that pilling on the fabric can be greatly reduced. The following are the common finishing treatments applied to the fabric surface mainly for anti-pilling. Number one, physical processes for reducing pilling. It's a summary of shearing or cropping, singeing, brushing, nothing. Last is heat setting or thermosetting. Those all mainly used to reduce the surface properties, thereby the pill formation is avoided. The next is chemical finishes for reducing the pilling. There are numerous chemical finishes to prevent pilling, usually accumulate on the fabric surface. The first one is the application of polymers, usually by padding and coating techniques. Another one is the application of enzymes to 100% cotton textiles to cause removal of loose fibers in the yarn itself to reduce the pilling tendency of the fabric. Let us discuss about the first one, application of polymers using padding and coating techniques. The polymeric formulations brings about the binding of loose fibers into fabric. The products normally used in these type of finishes are friction reducing lubricants to minimize the damage due to abrasion. Some of the examples for this type of polymeric finishes are amine treatment may be combined with other textile finishing operations like dyeing. It is performed on conventional treating equipment without any inhalation hazard, since the treating chemical has a low volatility. Furthermore, treatment of the textiles may be performed as a continuous operation where a relatively short chemical contact time is a necessity, since small concentration of the chemicals are required for short periods of time. The softeners is another polymeric finish, decreases the fiber to fiber friction by internal lubrication so that non-ionic organomodified silicone microemulsions and amino functional polyselections or such type of finishes result in decrease in fabric pilling formation. The next one is an enzymatic application. Usually it is a biofinish to 100% cotton textiles. Here, biopolishing with the cellulase enzyme is carried on for the 100% cellulosic or cellulose rich blend fabrics to eliminate the loose fibers so that clean and smooth surface with improved anti-pill rating can be formed. The biopolishing process targets the removal of small fiber ends protruding from the yarn surface, and thus the hairiness or fuss of the fabrics is avoided. Hydrolysis action of the enzymes weakens the protruding fibers to a maximum extent so that small physical abrasion force is sufficient to break the fibers on the yarn and thus remove them from the fabric surface. Biopolishing can be accomplished at wet processing time itself for convenient performance after the bleaching process. It is done both continuous or batch processes. However, continuous processes require some incubation time for enzymatic degradation to take place, thus removing the fuzz, makes the color brighter and the fabric structure more obvious and reduced peeling effects. Biopolish enzymes are actually a complex of cellulase enzymes. These enzymes bind the cellulose, producing a specific catalytic actions that results in the hydrolysis of 1,4-beta-diglucosidic linkage in cellulosic polymers. Openly, there are two types of biopolish enzymes. One is endobiopolish and another one is exobiopolish. The machines usually used for these kind of biopolymeric finishes are soft flow, jet and wash wheel. Sometimes mechanical agitation are more suitable for the process of biopolishing. Chemical finishes mainly accumulate on the fabric surface and thus the strength of the fibers are reduced on the yarn cross section. Reduction in strength of fiber to reduce pilling is easy way to cause the pills to fall from the fabric surface as soon as they get formed. The polymeric formula bring about the binding of loose fibers into the fabric. The products normally used in these type of finishes are friction reducing lubricants to minimize the damage. Acrylic copolymers can be modified to suit the requirements or normally used. Polymeric structures of synthetic fibers are altered to give fibers of lower tenacity is another approach to form anti-pill fabrics. The spun yarns put together in the fabric have lower strength, shows significant improvement in pill rating as compared to the fabrics made from normal polyester fiber. 100% cellulosic or cellulose-rich blends fabrics mainly to eliminate loose fibers are good compared to the man-made fibers because it results in improved pill rating. In conclusion, the module is summarized. Antistatic property can be brought out by simple reduction of charges by increasing the surface conduction power. By making the fiber more hydrophilic, is easy to form antistatic effect on the fabric surface. Most of the antistatic finishes are based on the mechanism by reducing the charge and increasing the surface conduction. The common practice is silicone emulsion when it is used produces the antistatic property by the reduced friction between the fibers, also sometimes have the advantage of soil release property. Antistat polypropylene is used on polyester fabrics exclusively in the concentration range of 5 to 10 GPL. It is added in finishing baths itself along with the other additives to form antistatic effect on polyester fabrics. The moisture regain of the fibers plays an important role in static dissipation. Higher the moisture regain, lower will be the static accumulation. Pilling behavior of fabrics in actual wear varies much more with the general conditions of use of individual wearers than in replicate fabric sample from the bulk lot from finished fabric subjected to controlled test methods. Understanding between the suppliers and buyers is very important in anti-pilling fabric formation because most of the customers require the anti-pilling finish. The degree of fabric pilling propensity is evaluated by comparing the test specimens, usually the standards available. It is usually graded by 5-point scaling system, where 5 represents no pilling, 1 represents very serious pilling. Pill identification is a crucial step in evaluating the fabric pilling appearance. Usually ICA box pilling method will be employed for anti-pilling testing. Numerous number of techniques are available to control the pill formation in the natural and synthetic fibers. Some of the recent advancements for anti-pilling fabrics and anti-pilling finishes are playing a vital role in reducing the pilling tendency on the fabrics. Some new technologies are definitely enhancing the aesthetic property by reduced pilling formation and thus the quality of textile fabrics and apparels against pills is significantly improved.